Welcome to the subject software engineering. At present we are in chapter system models, and today we'll be discussing structured methods. Point number one, structured methods is a systematic way of producing models of an existing system or system that is built. Students, in this chapter, that is system models, we have studied context models, behavior models, data models and object models. You very well know that only one model may not be sufficient to understand and analyze the system in total. So you may use combination of the models. So structured method is a systematic way of producing models of an existing system or of a system that we are going to design. Point number two, they were first developed in the year 1970s to support software analysis and design. Point number three, structured methods provide a framework for detailed system modeling as a part of requirement elicitation and analysis. Students, you very well know requirement elicitation and analysis is very important phase of system development. That is, after feasibility study, you have this requirement elicitation and analysis phase. In this phase, you study the system, existing system or system that you are going to build in total. So structure methods provide a framework for detailed system modeling, which will help us in requirement elicitation and analysis. Point number one, most structured methods have their own preferred set of system models. Students, you very well know there are different structured methods. So here, different structured methods have their own preferred set of system models, which will help to build the system. Point number two, they usually define the process that may be used to derive these models and set of rules and guidelines that apply to the models. Okay, so these structure methods define the process how you should develop the system, okay, and derive the models and set of rules or guidelines that will help to design the models. Point number three, standard documentation is produced for the system. Students, you very well know documentation is very important part of a system development. Okay, so you have studied earlier SRS, okay, or IEEE standard of documentation. So structured methods also help you to go or carry out documentation. Next, point number one, CASE tools, that is computer aided software engineering tools, are usually available for method support. These tools support model editing and code and report generation and provide some model checking capabilities. Students, computer aided software engineering tools, you very well know, come handy for the development of the software. So these tools support the editing part and the code development and report generation, okay, in case of software development. Point number two, structured methods have been applied successfully in many large projects. Point number three, they can deliver significant cost reduction because they use standard notations and ensure that standard design documentation is produced. Students, you know, as structured methods, okay, are very helpful in development of the system. They are applied for the large projects, and these methods can help in reduction of the cost as they use standard notations and standard design and documentation which is produced. But there are certain weaknesses in these structured methods. We'll try and understand what are these weaknesses. One, number one, they do not provide effective support for understanding or modeling non-functional system requirements. Students, you very well know, okay, non-functional requirements are common to all the systems that you may develop, but functional requirements speaks about the domain or the methods or particular domain area. So these structure methods, okay, are not useful for non-functional system requirements. They are only useful for functional system requirements. Point number two, they are indiscriminate in that they do not usually include guidelines to help users decide whether a method is appropriate for a particular problem. Students, you know, the structured method is a general tool. So these applying these methods of, okay, are indiscriminate. They will not distinguish between the various systems that you are developing. You will not come to know whether a particular method is appropriate. Point number three, they often produce too much documentation. Point number four, the models that are produced are very detailed. Users often find them difficult to understand. Students, these structured methods, you know, provide a lot of documentation, and these provide a detailed method of developing a system. So the developer is often confused and it is difficult for him to understand, because unwanted, okay, structures would also be developed. Case tools, that is computer-aided software engineering tools. Point number one, analysis and design case tools support the creation, editing, and analysis of the graphical notations used in structured methods. Students, you very well know case tools are available, that is computer-aided software engineering, which is very useful for software developer to develop the system. The tools support in creation, editing process, and analysis of the graphical notations used in the structured methods. Point number two, figure in the next slide shows the components of a case tool for structured method support. Students, in the next slide, you will see a diagram which will show the components of a case tool for a structured method support. So in this diagram, you will see an analysis and design workbench. Students, I will send this diagram, okay, in the PDF file, which will be very clear to you. Also, what are the components in these rounded rectangles, that is given in the next slide. But still, I will try and explain to you. Okay, in this, you got in the central, there is a rectangle, and it is surrounded by 8 rounded rectangles. Okay, the central edged rectangle is central information repository. Okay, in the first row on the left hand side, you have got data dictionary. Okay, second rectangle in the first row is structured diagramming tools, and the third rectangle in the first row is report generation facilities. Okay, in the middle row, okay, the first left side is code generator, and extreme right side is query language facilities. In the very bottom row, you have got in the left side forms creation tools. Okay, and in the middle, in the bottom row, you have got design analysis and checking tools. And in the bottom row, very right side, you have got import and export facilities. Students, details about this you will see in the next slide. you will see this diagram, okay, very correctly in the PDF file. At present, don't worry, okay. We'll go for detailed discussion of the various rectangles in this. The components of case tools. Students, what diagram you have seen earlier, all those rounded rectangles are discussed here. So you find in this the various components are there, such as diagram editors, repository query language, okay, design analysis and checking tools, a data dictionary, report definition and generation tools, forms definition tools, import export facilities, code generators. At present, okay, we'll study diagram editors, repository query language, and in the next slides we'll study the other components. So first we'll study diagram editors. So diagram editors are used, as the name, it is editor, it will help you to carry out the diagram edition, are used to create object models, data models, behavior models, etc. Okay, students, so diagram editors help you to develop a model. It could be object model, could be data model, or could be behavior models. All these models can be developed. These editors are not just drawing tools, but are aware of the types of entities in the diagram. So they will take into consideration entities in the diagram and help you to draw the system models. They capture information about the entities and save this information in the central repository. Students, you know there is a central repository in the middle, okay, of this diagram. So all the information about the entities will be saved in this central repository. Next, we'll study repository query languages. So repository query languages, as the name itself suggests, these are query languages. So these allow the designer to find designs and associated design information in the repository. Okay, so this repository query language help you to design and find associated design in the information in the repository. Some more tools are design analysis and checking tools, a data dictionary, and report definition and generation tools. First we'll consider, that is point number 3 here, design analysis and checking tools. So these tools that process the design and reports on the errors and anomalies. These may be integrated with the editing system so that the user errors are trapped at an early stage in the process. Students, so as the name itself suggests, these are design analysis and checking tools. So this will help you to process the design, and if there are any errors, okay, or anomalies, these will be reported. Okay, so these are integrated with the earlier, okay, diagram editors, and the user's errors are known at very early stage. This will save your software development time. Point number 4, a data dictionary. You very well know what is a data dictionary. So data dictionary maintains the information about the entities used in a system design. Okay. Point number 5, report definition and generation tools. As the name itself suggests, that take information from the central store and automatically generate system documentation. So students, this tool helps you to develop the report and generate the report. Next components are form definition tools, import export facilities, and code generators. So point number 6, form definition tools. So these allow screen and document formats to be specified. Students, form definition tools help you to design screen format and document format. Point number 7, import export facilities that allow the interchange of information from the central repository with other development tools. Students, you very well know that there is a central repository, so information would be extracted from central repository. Also, information will be passed on to the central repository. So this import export facility will allow to interchange the information from the central repository with other development tools. Point number 8, code generators. So these that generate code or code skeletons automatically from the design captured in the central store. So these code generators will help you to generate the code or skeleton of the code. Now we'll understand case tools. Point number 1. Most comprehensive case tool sets allow user to generate a program or program fragment from the information provided in the system models. Students, you very well know case tools can help the programmer in designing or generating a program from available information from the system model, or it could help to develop a part of the program that is called as program fragment. Point number 2, case tools often support different languages, so the user can generate a program in C, C++, or Java from the same design model. Students, you know, case tools can help the programmer to develop program in any language, whether it could be C, C++, or Java, from the same design model. So choice of the language in which code is generated can be given by the software developer. Point number 3, because models exclude low level details, the code generator in the design workbench cannot usually generate the complete system. Hence, some hand coding is usually necessary to add details to the generated code. Students, you know very well know, models are just abstract. They will not give all details. This is what we have been studying till now. So since models do not give all details, it is difficult for the code generator, in the design workbench to generate a complete program. Hence, human being has to write some part of the code. So students, today we are touched the last topic of the system models, that is structured methods. So I try to understand what is a case tool, how it is useful for structured method support. I'll be sending PDF of this. You please write this in your notebook, and then if there is any doubt, you can give me a call, and from tomorrow onwards or next period onwards, we'll proceed to the next chapter. I hope you will go through whatever PDF notes I have given and whatever video I am sending and understand this. If you, thank you.